think a lot of you will recognize this. It's Frosted Pumpkins Storytime Classics. And turns out, this is still January 2nd. Turns out I'm not that good at putting stuff away and getting to my chores. So what I did was I finished the frame that I needed to work on, which was this one. What I do is I try to stay ahead by a frame. So I have an empty frame ready to stitch, and then once I stitch another frame, I'll fill this one in. But now I'm ready, and you can see I've started the cue snapping process. This is going to be Alice in Wonderland. So here's a close-up of that one. As you can see, I'm doing my frames in not in the charted colors. What happened was when I was buying the week's dye works that the frames call for, she didn't have the ones I needed in stock. And so I got this other one and I really liked, and yeah. So I'm doing all the frames in one sheen or color of week's dye works. It's 1284. I'm not sure what the name of it is, but let's see. There we go. Week's dye works, 1284. It's kind of a gray, a green with a bit of gray in it. And that's what I'm doing all my frames in. So Alice in Wonderland will be going in this frame. And I basically stitch everything according to the chart except for the black. The black gets subbed out for something not so harsh. And I guess that's all I have to say about this one. But now I really need to get to my chores. But then I'll get back to stitching. I've got a mini finish. So I've been working on Storytime Sampler, Frosted Pumpkin Stitchery. And my goal was to finish one frame, and I was working on this frame. And then to complete the inside of the previous frame that I had done, which is the Alice in Wonderland. So there she is. I'm planning on doing all the back stitching at the end for the entire thing. So there's no back stitching there. There's a little vial, I guess. There she is, the white rabbit, Alice, Cheshire Cat. I am thinking that I will likely outline the interior frame, maybe in a gray. The only big changes I've done is all my frames are in a week's dye works, and instead of using black 310, I've subbed in 3799, which is kind of a dark, dusty gray. So I've got these four frames done so far. Next time around, my goal will be to put in the frame that's here and then fill in this interior. The reason I'm doing them like this is because I'm pretty sure I'm going to run out of my week's dye works skein that I have. I bought quite a few, but I've been using it for other things. I really like this color. So that's where that's going to go. But Peter Pan is done, Sherlock is done, and Alice is done. So put that away to rest until it comes around again. Next in the rotation, oh, I have a rotation. Next in the rotation is Tulip Time, which I have been working on for ages. It's a full coverage before, and I started it before I knew what full coverage was. And I've actually worked on it a fair bit recently, so I think I'm going to make my goal with this one maybe a time-based goal, like maybe work on it half an hour or an hour and then move on to the next thing. Here's what I've got so far. To back up a bit so you can see it. So you can see some of the flowers here, the house, some of the, I don't know what that's called in English, the framing, the Fachwerk, I don't know. And then the tree is taking shape. And actually, I'm kind of finding it interesting to look at this through my phone because I can kind of see more of the picture taking shape than when I'm actually stitching. There is so much confetti up here in the tree. And so, and I've done, yeah, this big stretch of blue, which is all solid. So I think my goal will be something like stitch for this on an hour. But before I do that, good old days of gold is going to get another color, color number 4. And I'm going to go with one of the oranges. Not entirely sure which one. So just a quick reminder, I almost forgot to say the date again. It is February 3rd. And we had a massive storm overnight. The wind has finally calmed down. I have an exposed north wall. There's no trees or neighbor to block the wind. So when there's a storm, I hear it. But the roads have been closed. They're just starting to open up now, which meant that I didn't go to my morning appointment. More stitching time. So I'm gonna add in an orange and we'll see what that does to the overall look of the piece. There we go. I'll finally be able to put, I'll pick one of the oranges that shows up in this block down here, this quilt block. Although now that I look at it, they're more yellow than orange. Oh, I guess there's some orange in the middle there. Pick one of those. And I'm guessing here and here we'll get a fair bit of stitching too. All right, see you in a bit. I also wanted to just kind of pop in and show you how I've organized my, or reorganized my floss. The labeler ran out halfway through and I had to move a few things around so the numbers aren't entirely accurate, but I can fix that easily enough once I get a new labeler tape. So what I have done is, I mean, obviously my DMC threads are there. In this top unlabeled bin, I've got, oh, by the way, the newer DMC boxes, instead of having an actual hinge, they just have a flap of what's supposed to be flexible plastic. And my last 2 or 3 that I've bought came broken. And it seems to be a fairly common problem. Now, it's not a huge problem in terms of using the box, except when you drop it and the whole thing flies open. All right, so these are my doubles. And I took them out because I couldn't fit things in to the other boxes if I included the doubles. So the idea is if I run out of floss, I'll check here first before I go out and buy more. And there are my blank cartridges. There's that, that's fairly straightforward. And I'm not gonna open each of the regular DMC boxes, but I have a box of specialty stuff. So, these here are rayon. Now, I don't think DMC make them anymore. They're incredibly slippery and difficult to work with, but I've got them. There's a couple pearls there, a couple old DMC variegated, some new DMC variegated, and several of those I got from my Secret Santa through Canadian Stash Unload. Here's my Lonely Classic Colorworks. I just really like that red, so I bought it. Week's Dye Works, an extra skein. And then here are all my other week's colors. I bought all of these because I liked them. A DMC Gold Metallic that hardly ever gets used. My extra Krennics. The Krennics that are being used with projects are in the bags with those projects, but there it is. And here is my Sulky Sliver thread for gridding. And I figured it made sense to keep my Thread Heaven together with my Krennic. So specialty threads. And then I can quickly show you one. I mean, everybody knows what DMC looks like, right? So I try to keep it to about 6 bobbins per container-ish. Some of them have more than one skein wound on them, and then they're really fat, but and some of them are winding down and then less of them. But I find if I have 4 or fewer bobbins, then they tend to fall down and get out of order and be hard to pull out. So for a while I had them standing upright. So for example, They were all like this. And it's easier to read the numbers that way, but I found that every time I put them back in, the edge of the plastic would catch on the floss from the other two sides, and it was just a pain. So I ended up putting them all back this way. And this way you can see the colors. So there's what that looks like. And then my last box is really just a few odds and ends. So needle packages that I've gotten from, these are from a couple Frosted Pumpkin kits. Some very small highlighters. I don't know where I got them. Oh, clearly I got them at Staples. They don't last forever. They're small, but they're really handy, especially when you're taking your stitching somewhere. And then I need to stock up, but here's my neutrals, my 310 black, my Ecru, my B5200 white, and my plain white. So there we go. I know I have another, I think B5200 in another. So that's the other thing that I did. Almost all of my kitted projects, I unkitted them and put them back in the set. And the only exceptions I made to that were, I have this really small box that I got from a friend, perfect for traveling. So what's in here is Happily Ever After, the Frosted Pumpkin Stitchery new stitch along. And then on this side, I'm working on the third of three Give Thanks ornaments. And that's in there too, because that's a project that I like to take along with me when I go places. And there's my Weeks Dye Works that I'm using for the lettering and also for the frames on my Storytime Sampler. Apparently I'm on a real Frosted Pumpkin kick right now. So there's my new system. We'll see if it gets tweaked anymore. Right now I'm really happy with it. Color number four is done. It took me a bit longer than the others did because there's more here. And I made a couple mistakes that took less than 20 stitches of frogging. But so while I was doing that, I got my YouTube to watch list, watch later list, down to below 200. It's pretty good. It also means I've watched about 100 episodes since the beginning of Christmas break. That's a lot of watching. Anyways, Days of Gold from Cross Stitcher Magazine, September 2016 issue. And here's what the actual cross stitch looks like. So I now have every single motif stitched except for, there's a tiny little vine, flowery vine thing here, and then a similar one, I think it's here, or maybe here. But they're quite, here I'll show you the pattern, these bits, that one and that one. But every single decently sized motif has some good stitching in it now. And you're beginning to be able to see the quilt blocks and the leaves and the house. And that quilt block, there's the beginnings of some mushrooms, the pumpkins. Right now they look like crazy tulips. And a tree with fallen leaves. And this is another quilt block. So where's the orange? I think next I'll do a yellow or maybe a brown. Doing a brown would help. For example, it would give structure to the tree. Makes placing things a bit easier. Even though with the gridding, it's not that big a deal. I did discover here, this top quilt block. I was stitching the orange, and I got to the center, and I had an even number of stitches, so I wasn't going to come down to a point of one stitch. Didn't take long to find the error. This green, I had stitched one row up. So that meant I had to take out everything. And that bit of green too. But in the end, it wasn't that big a fix. Not that big deal. Big a deal. Alright. So it's evening now on the 3rd of February. And I need to do adulty things like take out the recycling and make a decent meal because I've been stitching all day. The next thing on my stitchy agenda is Tulip Time. Sorry, you're seeing this beautiful view of my ottoman. I'll just show you the picture of where it's supposed to be headed. Tulip Time. There goes the pack of thread. And what I've got so far is a little bit here, a little bit here, a little bit here, and some of this blue. And I think for this one, I'm going to give myself an hour and to stitch as much as I can. But I think that'll be tomorrow's project. That is my thought on that matter. And did I say it's February 3rd? I've been doing that now. It's January 3rd. January, not February. All right, I will see you when I have updated Tulip Time. I did an hour of work on Tulip Time. And it's not like you can see a huge amount of progress, but what I've been trying to do is fill in these little bits and work that way. And hopefully end up eventually filling this in, and then I can fill that in. So what I've been doing is I'll look at a vertical line of stitches, and usually whatever empty hole shows up next, that's what I'll work on. Every once in a while I get sick of that and I do something else, but that's what I've been doing here. So I managed to make a 2 or 3 row advance. It's kind of like World War I. You spend a lot of time, World War I without the horrible death toll. You spend a lot of time and make very slow advances. With all this sky and tree stuff going on. And the timer beeped when I was there. So that's where I'm stopping for now. And but it was enough to feel like I made some decent progress at least. So next is going to be a new start, because this is next. I've got a few patterns that I'd like to start, but this one came in a CD case, It's a Lizzie Kate. I've never done a Lizzie Kate before, so that's a first for me. Giggle boxers. And I've got someone in mind for this piece. Well-behaved women rarely make history. It comes with this wee button, and it comes with this fabric, which I'm just holding it closer to my eyes. I believe it's a linen. It's kind of a stiff linen, so I don't know if it has some kind of starch on it or something, but it'll loosen up. Anyways, that's the next start. There's 5 or 6 weeks dye works listed, and I think I might have 1 or 2 of them. So we'll see if I just stick to the DMC or not. I'm not entirely sure what I'll do. So my goal with this one is just a plain old make a start. I'm not going to grid or anything. It's quite small and the count isn't too tiny. So you start. Yay! I finished my goal for this Lizzie Kate design last night, so that would have been the 4th of January. It's my first Lizzie Kate ever, and I'm doing it in all DMC just because I wanted to start it right away, so I didn't have time to collect the week's dye works that, and other fibers that are suggested. Basically, I wanted to just get all the words done that I could fit into one frame, and it's a small frame I was using, 6 inch maybe smaller, 4. Well-behaved women rarely make history, and what I have is behaved women rarely make. So I love how easy these charts are to follow. It's kind of a weird linen, it's quite stiff, but it's loosening up, so I'm doing it 2 over 2. There we go. Which is a bit loose, but I've heard other people mention on Flosstube, when you've got kind of a primitive style going, it's okay to not have such a full coverage. And I think once I wash it, that will help it settle out as well. So I'm okay with that. Won't get as much time for stitching today, but today the 5th, that is. But I'm hoping to once I get home this evening. I did this at a friend's, and when I was done this section, I started the brown on Days of Gold. I don't have that with me right now to show you. And I'm almost done that. So when I'm done that, there'll be another update. It's really starting to come together. In the meantime, this is what I worked on. This will be my next goal piece, my next rotation piece. This is the Winter Sampler by Jan Lynn. I have the charts for the other three seasons as well, but I haven't started them yet. I'm working this on this a linen, and it's taken a while. There's a lot to stitch here. I've done very little back stitching so far. I've done this bit of text here. I think that might be it for back stitching so far. And I've decided to include some crinic wherever there's snow, and that's slowing me down a bit too, but I like the effect, so. So we've got the word winter up here that's going in. The skate boot is done, minus the back stitching. The lace down the side here, the Valentine's girl is done. There's a lot of backstitch background detail, so you can see in the chart there, that needs to go in. And then I've started this, well, the snowman himself is pretty much done. And then here's an oval with a Santa in it. And over here is a skier. Kind of an old-timey looking skier, and that's all I've got so far. So I'm not 100% sure what my goal will be. What I might do is pick one mini frame to finish, and if I do that, I think it'll either be the skier or the top of this snowman bit, or it might be this sort of silent night town stretch here, and it goes on beyond to this side. Those are some of my thoughts. I really like this design, but it sure takes a long time to stitch. That's okay. I think this is one that I would have started in hand, so I'm going to start stitching it with a frame now, and that might speed things up a bit. Speaking of which, I was looking at the Lowry stand today, this morning, and I did discover that it seems to be cheaper if you order it from Lakeside Needlecrafts rather than from soandso.uk by about £20, which is about $30 Canadian difference. The problem is, it's even on Lakeside Needlecrafts, they have the stand, and that's just the stand, not the extender bar or anything, for about £75, I think. So that's not cheap. That's a to be saved for type of thing. But, oh, there's something else I could finish. A little bit of backstitching here to complete this phrase. Yeah, there's my winter sampler. It's the evening of, I think, January 5th. It's Thursday at any rate. And I was adding 436, the light brown, to the pattern. And so, here's what we've got now. This will make it a fair bit easier to place the leaves on the tree. And then, still just this lonely center to this quilt block here, but a lot got put in on this apple basket, the deck around the house, the pie crust, and then there were little bits, for example, the stems of the mushroom. And, well, that was about it. There wasn't a lot for this one. The next color I think I would like to tackle is 601. Now, by itself, it looks like this hyper bright pink, but the way it's used here, for example, it's the center of this leaf and it's this door. So it ends up feeling like red. Not the orangey reds that you see in the mushroom cap, but I don't know. This piece is really kind of fascinating me in terms of how colors change, or your perception of them changes depending what they're with. What they're used beside. And I really like that, because that's not my natural forte, so it's fun to just kind of observe how that works. I think actually I would like to add that color and maybe work on some gridding tomorrow for my happily ever after. But here's Days of Gold as far as it is now. Time to take a picture and put it up in Instagram and then call it a night. It's the morning of January 6th, and here's Days of Gold that I've been working on. So I've been working on a DMC 601, the sixth color now, maybe? And here we are. I also had to add this branch in the brown that I'd forgotten. So it's actually a very strong pink, almost a fuchsia, but it sort of ends up reading red. The way this works. So there was the center of that leaf put in, a bunch of leaves on this tree, on the ground, shading on the big pumpkin, the house door, a couple heart motifs in a quilt square and in a border type of, there'll be two other hearts kind of here and here, there we go. Center of this flower at the end of the vine. This poor flower pot hasn't had much done to it lately. Sorry, I haven't talked yet today. An apple in the apple basket got some of it, and then a little bit more finally got added to this motif. There are still two border bits here under the pumpkins and here that haven't had anything done to them. But I was thinking it's time for me to do a yellow. But then I realized up here by the pie, these random bits, there we go, these random bits, there's a darker bit of random bits up here, and not much, and there's sort of a pink that's between this one and the one color I just completed. And I'd like to do those before I do the background filling in, which is one of the yellows. So the symbol for that is an S. So that would be $8.99 DMC. So it'll either be that or one of the greens, I think, that I'll go with. Now the next thing in my rotation is Winter Sampler. I talked about what I want to do there already, but I think the light is really good today. It's one of those super crisp, cold, clear days, so I think I want to do just a little bit of gridding, and then I have a to-do list that's really long, but we'll see. Maybe I'll get to my winter sampler and do a small goal on that one, and then maybe get back to Days of Gold. I'm really loving how it's coming together. I know I've said that a few times already, and I will probably say it a few times again before I'm done. And I think the gridding is playing a huge part in that. I have had to frog a couple things, but never more than 20 stitches. It's Aida, so it comes out easily. And it's so easy to A, not make a mistake, and B, when I do make a mistake, find it quickly and fix it. So, see you next time. Probably not the most visually exciting update ever, but I've been working on gridding for Happily Ever After, and of course I just kind of decided to grid the whole fabric section, so that's what I've got so far. And of course, if you've ever gridded, you'll know once you've got about half the lines in, it really starts to pick up speed because I don't have to count anymore. I can just go by these little gaps. So I just put in four of the long lines and I need four more of those, and then the short lines will go nice and quickly. But it is rather satisfying. And in the meantime, I am down to 179 watch later YouTube videos. How awesome is that? I think it's time to get up and move around and do chores and things. And we'll see how the light is when I get back, and maybe I'll do another row or two of gridding. That's where I'm at in the meantime. Oh, if you're interested in the fabric, it is Crystal Helix, Cashel 28 count, from Picture This Plus. It's the one that came in the kit for Happily Ever After by Frosted Pumpkin Stitchery. So, getting kind of excited. We're getting close to when they'll publish the first pattern. So, oh, I did want to share. I'm using a Selkie sliver thread. Here it is. So I can get it to focus for you. Selkie sliver metallic. This is a black. And it's a bit slippery, so it's kind of hard to anchor. So over here, for example, focus. I started by just taking a couple stitches, and I'm noticing those ones tend to work themselves out. So what I've been doing now, I'll give you a better example. I've just been taking more stitches. So here, for example, that's about four back stitches. So they double back on themselves. And then I leave maybe a 3/4 inch tail so that it doesn't work itself out quite so easily. But it's not long enough to interfere in any stitching, I don't think. So that's what I'm doing there. All right, talk to you next time.